Okay, this is Troy Hager with another Google Drive tutorial. As you can see, I'm on the Google page. I am logged in. This is a new feature with Google. They have these little icons up here that you can tell that you're logged in. This, of course, is the apps that are available to you. You've got Sites, the search engine, Google Drive, which we'll talk about today, and Calendar. There's the infamous More button that Google uses if you want more apps. Also, Images is very popular, so they actually have a link right here. So I am going to go into Drive, and we talked about this before. Today we're going to talk about creating a form. So a form is basically attached to a spreadsheet. You create the form with different questions and send out a link to the live form, and people can put their information into the form. That information goes into the spreadsheet, and then you can manipulate the spreadsheet however you want, sort it, and analyze the data in however you want. So it's great for surveys. It's great to pull a class about what kind of pizza they want for the party. We use it all the time polling teachers about different things. Anyways, as you can see, there's a red button on the left-hand side. It says Create, and down here you've got Form. So when you first go into Create a Form, it asks you what kind of theme that you want, and also to title the form. So we will just put tutorial. And they have a bunch of different ones. There's not a huge amount to pick from, so I'm just going to choose the default form. And then we have the editing page here. So let's take a look. You've got your file, edit, view, etc. Menus up here. You've also got a bunch of buttons here. You can change the theme. You can go to the spreadsheet that's attached to this form and view the responses. This is a button where you can turn off the form and no longer accept responses, which is kind of handy if you have a deadline or something. We do that sometimes with parent surveys. And then you can view the live form and see how it actually looks to the people that are going to be using it. Up here at the top, there's three different checkboxes. And this one always defaults, require Hillsborough City School District login to view this form. So I usually uncheck that box. It asks you or tells you a couple warnings. So I usually leave all three of this unchecked. This is the name that you just put in. You can change this if you want to add something. So the first thing is a question that you can put in here. This is kind of an editing the first item on the form. So you have a question. Let's say you want to get their name. So you could say first name. You also have a field for any help text that you could write, you know, if you want to explain what you want right here. And then question type. So you have a lot of different types of question. You have text, paragraph, multiple choice, check boxes, choose from a list, scale, grid, date, and time. So for just a name, we would want just a small text box like this. And you also have a checkbox to require this question. So this will require the user to put in their answer, and they cannot submit it until their answer to this question is put in the box here. So, and then you can press done. And that's how it looks. So you have first name, and then the box where they put it in. Now these three buttons over here, this one means that you want to go back and edit this question or this item. This one is that you can duplicate this one to the next. And this is, you don't want it all, you want to trash it, delete it. So let's duplicate this one. We can put last name. Then you would have one column in your spreadsheet that would have the first names and one column with the last name. And I want to require this, so let's press done. Well, you can also add an item by going down here, and you can select the different types of items that you want. So let's make a multiple choice question. So let's say we're having an ice cream party, and we want to pick the ice cream that your class wants. So we've got multiple choice here. We've got option one, chocolate, vanilla, and strawberry, or whatever. And I'm going to require this question. I'm going to press done. So something happened here, so I want to go back because we lost the chocolates for some reason. So I'm going to add chocolate here. And there we have our three different types of flavors. So once you're done, you can actually go and view this form live and see how it looks. So this is a plain Jane kind of default theme. It has the title up here, a little asterisk with required, and you, as you can see, each item is required. So I can put in my first name and make my selection and then submit. If I leave out one and press submit, as you can see, this says this is a required question, so it makes the person put in their answer. So after I submit it, I'll talk a little bit about this later, but after I submit it, I can go back here and view the responses. So now we're going to go and check out the spreadsheet that is attached to this. This is how it looks. So the first column is always a timestamp, and that is exactly what date and what time. And this is a 24-hour clock, so you know what time they put in their answer. And obviously you have one column for first name. This is the first item. Second item is last name. And the third item is the ice cream in our case. So you can sort by, you know, last name if you wanted. You could sort, probably in this case it'd be best to sort by flavor. So you can also create some charts and graphs to analyze this as well. So that in a nutshell is how to create a form. Okay, at the bottom you also have some items. You saw when we submitted the form, it showed a link to submit another response. I usually don't want to have the same person submit another response because that would mess up our data. So usually, again, I uncheck all of these. So that's pretty much it. Now, how do you get this out to the people that will fill it out? You can press this Send Form button at the top, and you can either enter all of the names, email addresses, or whatever, or you can just copy this link. So when I click on it, it selects it all, and you press Control C to copy. The easiest way to do this, in my opinion, is to create an email and email it out to whoever you want. For teacher surveys, we do, you know, Crocker teachers, all the district. For parent surveys, we're able to email it out just to 8th grade parents or whatever. For your class, you can put this on your website. And you could create a link on a web page and tell your kids to go up and access it that way. I think that forms are very helpful and they're very powerful. You can use them. There's a million different ways that you can use them. And they're also very simple to make. So after you make the form, you can actually go back to your Google Drive, and you should see two different files here in your library. This one is the form. This little icon is what they use for a form. And then this is the spreadsheet that's attached to the form. They name it responses.